A deputy director of the Aadhaar body has registered an FIR against the Tribune newspaper and its reporter Rachna Khera after her sensational report on how full Aadhaar details can be accessed by paying anonymous sellers mere 500 rupees via Paytm. The FIR also names Anil Kumar, Sunil Kumar and Raj, all of whom were mentioned in the Tribune report as people Khera contacted in the course of her reporting. The report had created a massive controversy over the leakages in the Aadhaar system, though on Thursday, the Aadhaar body denied any breach or leak of the Aadhaar data. And the Tribune tweeted that the FIR had been registered against its reporter. They used the hashtag, one of the hashtags, shoot the messenger, while tweeting that. And the Editors Guild has condemned the FIR and expressed concern in a statement. They said the Guild condemns the UIDAI, that's the Aadhaar body's action to have the Tribune reporter booked by the police. It is clearly meant to browbeat a journalist whose investigation on the matter was of great public interest. It is unfair, unjustified and a direct attack on the freedom of press. Instead of penalizing the reporter, UIDAI should have ordered a thorough internal investigation into the alleged breach and made its findings public. The Guild demands that the concerned union ministry intervenes and have the cases against the reporter withdrawn. All right, Rachna Khera, the reporter who filed that Aadhaar breach story for the Tribune, now joins me on the phone line. Rachna, you have been booked for cheating and forgery. How do you view this FIR?
I think this is the FIR which I have earned it, and I'm happy at least the UIDAI has taken some action into the breach being reported, into the Aadhaar database from the last many years. And I really hope that this FIR, the government of India, should see that what all breaches are being there, and the government should take an appropriate action over it.
Rachna, you still stand by that, by your story?
Yes, of course. I stand by every word I have written into the report.
As the Editors Guild has said, do you think this is an attempt to browbeat you to take back your story, a case of shooting the messenger?
See, it is yet to be seen as to who has filed an FIR. I have not received a copy of the FIR. For me, it is difficult to comment on the issue right now. Because if it is being filed by the UIDAI officials, my comment would have been different. So right now, I would like to refrain myself from commenting on anything on the issue.
It's the deputy director of the UIDAI who has filed the FIR, Rachna.
These are media reports. I have to see that because I was told that there are some media reports which state that it's not the UIDAI, but someone else has also filed the FIR. So until and unless I've got a copy of the FIR, I think... it's not right to comment on the issue.
Rachna, there's a lot of support coming from within the journalist community. What has your organization, the Tribune, decided?
I'm very happy that not only the local media, the Chandigarh media, the Delhi media, and as well as the international media, is, a lot of support they are, in fact, they have assured. And I'm happy that the issue has really... applauded by all the journalists also. So I'm happy the Tribune is providing me all legal support, and we are sure that we will going to do something about it.
Rachna, are you going to petition the government like the Editor Guild also demands to withdraw the FIR against you?
I'm sure the government of India is taking a note on the happenings or the latest, happenings in the case. And I'm sure that we are going to hear something very soon.